Okay, let's do this. On the right side, you can see the result of my code. This code finds the shortest path from the top left to the bottom right. On the left side, you can see the code itself. If you want a copy of the code, you can find a link in the description below. If you want to find out how this works, I will explain that right now. So first, I define my level width and height. I also predefine my level layout. I use the list function as a convenience. This converts the level to a 2D grid. Now I define my getShortestPath function. This takes a level, a start coordinate, and an end coordinate. The algorithm will explore all possible search paths. All explored paths will be stored here. It begins with the start coordinate. This variable keeps track of all visited coordinates. The algorithm will explore each coordinate once. Now I will keep exploring until all paths have been explored, and if that happens, then there is no path to the end coordinate. I retrieve the oldest path in search paths. From this path, I explore all new possible routes. A path consists of multiple coordinates. I will take the last coordinate. That is our current position on this path. I extract the current x and y for readability. If the current coordinate is the end coordinate, then return the current path. That means we have found our shortest path. And now I will generate all next moves with a helper function. This function retrieves all next moves for the current x and y. I subtract 1 from x to move left. I add 1 to x to move right. I subtract 1 from y to move up. And I add 1 to y to move down. I use a dictionary for readability, then convert the values to a list for the algorithm. Now I will loop over each next move. I extract the x and y from this move. If the x is outside the level, skip this move. If the y is outside the level, also skip this move. If this coordinate is already visited, skip this move. And finally, if the current position is a wall, skip the move. If we are still in the loop, then we can add this coordinate to the current path. We also mark the current coordinate as visited. And that's it. That's the breadth first shortest path algorithm. I will get the shortest path from the top left to the bottom right. Next, I will animate the shortest path to confirm that it works. First, I need to import the time module for the animation. And now, for each coordinate in the shortest path, extract the x and y. Mark the current position in level with a dot. Print each row in the level on screen. And finally, add an empty line and wait a moment. And that's it. Now you can see the shortest path animated. If I change the level, it'll find another path. I hope this video was useful to you. Thank you for watching.